I spoke to Rebecca. She wants to FaceTime with you this week.
I don't want her seeing me like this.
Your sister doesn't care about your vanity, Alex.
Worrying about me is a distraction she can't afford.
Fine. But she's going to have some choice words for you when she gets home next month.
Just wait till she writes my eulogy.
You keep talking like that, and I am going to be the reason you're in this bed.
I know the statistics on leukemia, Mom.
You're going to make it through this. You know why? Because you're a Quinn.
And a Quinn never backs down from a fight.
That's my boy. Now get some rest. Check back on you later. Where are you, Sean?
All right, Quinn.
No. Not Rebecca.
The Commandant of the Marine Corps has entrusted me to express his deep regret that your daughter, Captain Rebecca Quinn, was killed in action.
The military has been in our blood for generations. My husband and I both served, and our children wanted to continue the tradition.
Except Sean?
Well, Sean tried to enlist, but was medically denied due to a heart murmur. That rejection always stuck with him.
Is that when he started having problems?
No, he spiraled when Will died. He was my oldest. Sean adored him. That's when he started drinking, got fired from his job, and fell in with a bad crowd.
Bad how?
Sean became secretive. He moved into a new apartment and disappeared for weeks at a time.
When's the last time you saw him?
6 months ago. He stopped returning my calls and just cut us out of his life. He doesn't even know about Rebecca. Please, find Sean. Bring him home.
Well, look who's here.
It's Murphy, I was doing.
I'm surprised you have the nerve to show your face at this house. Do you have any idea how hard Travis worked to get ready for your job interview? How much it meant to him? And you wouldn't even give him a chance.
Well, I appreciate your son's passion.
Oh, you most certainly do not.
Mom! Who is it?
Sheriff High Horse.
Hey, let him in.
Why? So he can come here and trample your dreams?
You must be Peter Daniels.
That's right.
Hazel Schwartz. I look after the place. They usually call me to bring out the welcome wagon. I bake some cookies for you. Chocolate chip.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
Just a little personal touch. I know all the best hiking trails. I'm happy to show you around. If you need something, some more cookies. I'm just a half mile up the road. Number 40, name's on the mailbox.
It's very nice of you.
Well, enjoy your stay, Mr. Daniels. If solitude's your thing, you came to the right place.
Was your son in treatment?
He'd tell you he was.
When he first got back, he was.
We'd like to talk to anyone who might have seen him or spoken to him recently. Friends, girlfriends.
None that we knew of.
Anybody he might have kept in touch with.
I think he pretty much lost touch with everyone.
Did you see him often?
A meal, change of clothes, hot shower. I'd do his wash for him. Some men never grow up.
That was just before he deployed the first time.
A Green Beret. That's a real accomplishment, Mrs. Meadows.
We are proud of him.
I'm sure you are.
It wrecked him. This damn war. He had no end of troubles when he finally came home. Now this. Take your time. We are back on the record in the deportation proceeding of Kareem SF. Mr. SF, it troubles me deeply that you pled guilty to a distribution charge you're now saying you did not commit. Can you tell me why you did this?
I hoped it would minimize the chances of me getting deported.
So you lied under oath.
Your Honor, I think you should stick to the law.
Yes, and I'm sorry for that.
Mr. SF, this admission calls into question your integrity, as well as everything positive that was said about you in this courtroom today. I've therefore come to the conclusion that despite the excessive community support shown here, I'm going to order your deportation.
Objection! The prior felony has been vacated.
Sit down.
Judge. I think we slept together at some point. In the woods.
No! She's drunk!
I am. When did Andy Belcher get to be so fucking hot?
Who is this?
Miss Herrera, the principal of Pacific Middle School. Who's this?
Martin Bishop, how can I help you?
What can I do for you, Martin?
I'm sorry, you called me.
No, my phone rang. You called me. Do you have a child enrolled here?
No. Not yet. Look, we just moved into the area. My son Jake is 11 years old.
Well, why don't you have Jake come by for half day tomorrow and we'll see how it goes.
Well, if you choose to have Sally work with me, I'd like to meet her and then interview you and your ex-husband.
Well, I doubt you'll ever meet him.
Is this most recent incident of the most concern for you?
Dr. Keener.
Call me Dr. Agna. That's what the kids do.
Of course, I know children do this. But not in public. I feel like Sally did this to punish me somehow for everything.
That must be a terrible feeling. You know, I'm very proud of how you found a way to behave so well, even when you get so angry at your mother sometimes. It's hard to control ourselves when we get so angry.
She just doesn't know that I'm mad.
As long as you know it. I told you your mom acts that way because she has stresses. Not because you're bad or that you did anything wrong.
Do you have any threes?
I said I'm very proud of you. Did you hear that?
Tell us a little bit about the kind of stuff you've written.
I'm not really allowed to talk about it.
AJ's a very successful lawyer.
Not anymore.
Like John Grisham. You quit to do what you love. Good for you.
Not exactly.
Everything okay?
I just wish I had more time to spend with you guys.
You're going?
Oh, Abby didn't tell you I have another engagement. But I've taken care of the bill. Have a lovely visit.
He's really busy.
Beth? Where the hell were you guys?
Come, sit down, talk to me for a minute.
No, wait, you need some time. Wait, no, Peter.
I don't care. Don't come in here, Bev.
Craig. Is that you, honey?
Don't come in here, Bev.
No.
Get
no,
back.
No,
get out of here.
Craig.
There's something in the closet.
Craig,
get out.
No.
You shot our son.
That is not Greg! Did you see that thing? I had no idea what that thing would do to us.
Your fear lost us our son.
It's not my son.
Yeah, you stand here all night and try to convince yourself that. I know it.